Hey everybody and welcome back to another redstone video. Today I will show you how to build this item frame combination lock. I built this one together with MDP on the Synergy server. Before that I already had a working design, however that one was sadly locational, so then MDP came in and just helped me to create this new design. So a huge thanks to him. This combination lock requires 4 digits, or you could also say 4 item frame inputs, which means that there's a total of 4096 possible combinations. You can obviously set the combination to whatever you want. This right here is the correct combination for this lock in particular. So let me just quickly enter it. And as you can see, this light now turns on, just to let me know that I entered the correct combination. And also in the back, this light turns on. Obviously, if you're building this, you can now have your output from here and just run this into a door like I have done right here. Now, in order to reset the combination, there are also 2 options. First off, you can just click this button. And then obviously I recommend putting the item frame back to a starter position. Or alternatively, from the inside you can also have a button in this position, which should also allow you to reset the combination. This combination lock is flush with the wall, so in theory you could also have blocks right here without any problem, so that you can actually have rooms below the main room here basically. Okay, this on the right here is just the example I basically used at the beginning of the video. Because the combination lock is so small that you can actually place a piston door directly next to it. This is the ultra compact 3x3 spiral piston door by Quippler. He's another great redstone YouTuber, so a link to this door and his channel can be found in the video description. Definitely check him out. As you can see, I also use a different combination for this one, so let me just quickly enter that one. And as you can see, the door opens up. And once again, to close it, you can just hit this button, or the one at the front again, and we just hit this button to show you that it also works. And yeah, you can just easily link it up. You can also take an output from over here, for example, and just run that into a piston door. If you do decide to build Quippler's piston door, just make sure to flip it so that these observers right here are in this position and not on the other side. But yeah, in the tutorial, I will only show you how to build the combo lock itself. If you also want to build the door, you can just take a look at Quippler's channel, where you can just find this one. Let's get started. For this build, you will require a wall that is at least 3 blocks wide and 4 blocks high. You will also need a space of 7 blocks behind that wall and 8 blocks of space below it. First off, just knock out this block right here and place a redstone lamp in its place. Then just place a stone button on this block right here. Make sure it is a stone button and not a wooden button. You can in theory also use blackstone, for example. And then behind that, just place a node block with a downwards facing observer below it, going into a block. Then another downwards facing observer right there with redstone dust on top of it. Then just go down 2 blocks like this and place redstone dust right here. Another downwards facing observer in this position with a repeater on top of it. Going into a block right here, a half slab in this position, and another block right here. Now place a bit of redstone dust on top of that block. A sticky piston right there, and then a redstone block at its face. And now when you click this button, this sticky piston right there should extend and retract twice. Now you want to go back to this sticky piston right there and just place two regular upwards facing pistons in these two positions. Place two blocks right here with a half slab in this position. Then just three bits of redstone dust on top of that. And on top of this piston right there, you now want to place a block, then a half slab, a block, a slab, block, slab, block, slab, block, so that you have four half slabs and five blocks. And then just take an observer output from this topmost block, and then another upwards facing observer on top of this observer going into a block with a downwards facing piston right there. And then for the other piston, just place two blocks, then a slab, a block, slab, block, slab, and then once again two blocks. And then take an observer output from this block in this direction with once again another upwards facing observer on top of that going into a block with a downwards facing piston right there. And if you now activate this, both of these should kind of shift twice. Go to the back, and now you want to place a comparator on top of this node block, a half slab right here with redstone dust on top. And then wherever you see a half slab in this column, just place a block next to that with redstone dust on top. And now just build a shape like this. With some more comparators right here. And redstone dust right here. And now just place comparators going in the opposite direction like this. And then just place some more blocks right here. And right here. With redstone dust on top of these few blocks. Comparators right here. And some more comparators right here. Now go back to this comparator right here and just place a temporary block above it. Then destroy this block right here and just place two observers right there and just place that block back in. Now place another observer pointing that way, and now you should see both of these faces when you destroy this block. Place a sticky piston right here with an observer on top of it going this way into another sticky piston with a redstone block at its face. Now just place two blocks right here, redstone dust on top of this one, and then a vortex repeater right there with a regular piston in front of that repeater pointing that way. And now when you activate this button, as you can see, these only shift once now. Next up, just go to this observer right here and place a one tick repeater on top of it, going into a downwards facing sticky piston with a redstone block right there. And now wherever you see one of these blocks, just go down by one and place a U-shape like this. So now you should have four of these U-shapes, and just place redstone torches along the center like this. Then some comparators on top of these blocks with barrels in front of them. Or you could also use chests. And now just place more comparators right here and make sure to set these to subtraction mode by just right-clicking them. Then place two bits of redstone dust right here. a repeater in this position. And now just wherever you see one of these barrels, place a slab next to it, a slab right here, next to this barrel, and so on. And now at the bottom, just place a block in this position, and also right here. And now just place redstone dust on top of all of these. Now place a block next to this bit of redstone dust, another one right here, with a redstone torch in this position, and then just place another bit of redstone dust right here, and this piston should retract. Next up, just place your item frame onto this redstone lamp, and place an arrow inside of it. And now you can just enter your desired combination. So I want mine to be bottom right, just confirm using this button. Then left, top right, and then top left. And as you can see, obviously nothing happened, because we will now need to program our combination into the lock basically. The way we can do this is using these barrels and the graphic which you can now see on screen. So this lower barrel right here is responsible for the first digit, this second lowest one for the second digit, and so on. So for the first digit, as you can see in the graphic on screen, I will now need to put two non-stackable items into this barrel, since my combination, or my first digit is bottom right. And as you can see, this redstone dust right here now turns off. And then for the second one, I will need 8 items for a left combination. And as you can see, these two bits of redstone dust turn off. And these ones are already off, because as you can see, there are no items inside of here. And the graphic also shows that for the top right, you don't need any items inside of this. And then finally, I will need 10 items for the top left position. And as you were just able to hear, this piston now extended, showing us that the combination is correct. And that means that we have now set our combination. Let's just test if it works. Just reset it by inputting another combination, or just another digit basically. So my combination is bottom right, left, top right, and then top left. And as you can see, the lamp now turns on. Okay, now I'm just gonna show you how to take an output from this. So you can just place a redstone torch right here with a block in this position, or you can also have the torch right here with redstone dust on top of there. Or if you want it to be even lower, just have redstone dust right there, and then a redstone torch in this position, and then for example redstone dust right here or right here. But yeah, that's pretty much how you take the output. And that also marks the end of this video. Let's just reset the combination. I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next video. Goodbye!